Place the IC LM358 on the breadboard. Make sure for the proper connection of the IC. Now, connect the 8th pin of the IC to the positive rail, the positive ground, right? And then connect the 4th pin of the IC to the negative rail, which means the negative ground. Now place a 500K pot, the potentiometer, and connect its right external pin, you can see in the picture, to the positive rail, which means the positive ground. Now connect the center pin of the potentiometer to the 6th pin of the IC, you can see in the picture. Then connect the left external pin to the negative rail. Now connect 100 nanofarad capacitor to the center pin and to the left external pin of potentiometer. Now connect another 100 nanofarad capacitor to the 3rd and 4th pin of the IC. You can see clearly in the picture. Next, insert a 5.6 megohms at 3rd pin of the IC and its another terminal to the negative rail of the breadboard. Now insert another 5.6 megohms at 3rd pin of the IC and its another terminal to the positive rail of the breadboard. Now connect a wire between the positive rails of the breadboard. This is done so as to connect the 5.6 megohms directly to the right external pin of the potentiometer to show the continuity. Now connect another 100 nanofarad capacitor to the 3rd and 4th pin of the IC. And next, insert another 5.6 megohms at 3rd pin of the IC and its another terminal to the negative rail of the breadboard. Connect a 100 nanofarad capacitor to the 2nd and 3rd pin of the IC and connect a 5.6 megohms to the 1st and 2nd pin of the IC. Now take a small wire and connect it to the 1st and 5th pin of the IC. You can see in the picture that yellow wire, which is the hookup wire connected between the 1st and 5th pin. Now the circuit is almost completed. Now take a 1 kilo ohm and connect it to the 7th pin of the IC and its another terminal to some nearest pin out. Now in order to obtain the output, you can insert an LED or even buzzer to the 8th pin of the IC and its another terminal to the pin out where the other terminal of the 1 kilo ohm is connected. You can see in the picture. Now, in order to receive the RF signal, you can insert an aerial, if available, or some normal connecting wire to the 2nd pin of the IC. At last, in order to complete the circuit, we can connect a 9 volt battery. Still, if you didn't get the output, you can verify the troubleshooting guide and you will definitely come to the conclusion.